The Ministry of Infrastructure says it is baffled at the request by the United Workers' Party for clarification on the redevelopment project for the Hewanorra International Airport. The ministry views it as a deliberate and calculated attempt to mislead the nation. Executive assistant in the ministry, Silas Wilson, stated that the entire redevelopment process was outlined and presented when the bill was debated and passed in the lower house of parliament on May 26, 2015. Additionally, he noted that a subsequent meeting was held on June 18th at SLASPA at the request of UWP political leader Alan Chastney.
The following persons were in attendance at that meeting. 1. Alan Chastney. 2. Guy Joseph. 3. The Vice Chair of the St. Lucia Air and Seaports Authority Board. 4. The St. Lucia Air and Seaports Authority General Manager. 5. A legal representative of SLASPA. And 6. A representative of the International Finance Corporation.
Mr. Wilson added that documents confirming the June 18th meeting were copied to opposition leader Dr. Gail Rigobert, which, according to him, furnished details on the redevelopment project. He says a member of the International Finance Corporation was also on hand to answer questions from the UWP representatives.
It is very surprising, therefore, that the UWP is suggesting that this project is shrouded in secrecy. Finally, SLASPA has for a long time lamented that the aircraft parking apron is incapable of accommodating wide-bodied aircraft when overcrowding of the apron occurs during peak periods. In 2014, SLASPA initiated studies to expand the parking apron to deal with this untenable situation. Tender documents and drawings were submitted to SLASPA.
The estimated cost of the project is $7.01 million and not the $28 million figure which was quoted by the UWP, according to Mr. Wilson. In his view, it is the United Workers' Party who was guilty of keeping the involvement of asphalt and mining in the Hewanorra Airport during its term in office a secret. A secret which Mr. Wilson says would cost the taxpayers $400 million. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas.